show your love for Kathy Matthews and Ryan Noy.
There we go. A little safer now, probably.
It's great to have family and friends all here from each side to celebrate together with us. Two of our favorite people coming together. Second, while this is unconventional, I want to share a few haikus that I've prepared just for tonight's occasion. That's right, haikus. Now, if you're wondering what the bleep is a haiku, and what is Katie's nerdy younger sister up there babbling about, let me explain. A haiku is a Japanese poem, usually three lines long, five syllables in the first line, seven in the second, and five again in the last line. I heard that rhyme. These rarely ever rhyme, and you'll see. I'll try some out. Here's an example. Haikus are easy, but sometimes they don't make sense. Hippopotamus. It's funny, right? Okay. She's a typical younger sister that loves borrowing my stuff. So this haiku is called Caitlin. Okay, first one. I know you hate that. Yes, you can wear my black boots, but they are not yours. Also, on several occasions, we've had the case of mistaken identity. So here's another haiku. Confusion up north. Why aren't you at the school dance? I am not Caitlin. Now let's talk about Bob for a minute. Kate has had to put up with her brother and I dishing out all sorts of nicknames. I won't get into them all, but recently, very recently, Bob saved the day for me. And he made me a hero at work, helping me write a few lines So I've given him a new nickname, very fitting for Bob's haiku. It's titled, Bobby Digital. Okay. Bob can write macros? This makes me very happy. Way to go, Katie. And finally, in closing, a serious haiku. This girl has her guy. This guy now has got his girl. Oh, I read that one. This guy has now got his girl. We love both of you. Cheers to my awesome little sister and my new brother, Ryan.
Thank you, Lindsay. The best man, Mr. Ray Murdoch.
Wow, this is a big crowd. The crowd was much smaller in my head when I started practicing this. So I went to the internet and spent some time to get some research about how long this speech should be and stuff. And after an hour and a half, what I finally realized was my fantasy football team's in ruins. We're here in a great chapter of their life, a new chapter and stuff. And the common thing that people ask for in weddings is, where did they meet? Where did it all begin? And if you guys don't mind, to help you guys out, I'd like to tell everyone, you know, where it is that you guys began. Are you guys all right? Okay. So many people may know this story, may not, and unless Caitlin told you, Bob, you might not know this, so it's too late now. She said yes. So Caitlin was working at Applebee's, and we all as a group went to go eat, and Bob kept on talking about how cute Caitlin was. And so Bob's a little shy, so I ended up excusing myself and went to the waiting table. So my buddy's really shy, and would you mind going out with him? And you know, I was like, look, I know he's shy, but here's $40. And she's like, first response goes, well, is there anything wrong with him? I would do some of the same thing. But I was like, no, it's all. And then I kind of thought for a second, yeah. He's probably going to make you pay for yourself and for him. So here's another 60. No, but this whole weekend's been great, and Bob's wonderful. He's a real loyal friend, admirable. And us friends have talked, and Bob is the cornerstone of our group. You know, he doesn't care what you do. He's always there for you, loyal, friendly. And it was interesting hearing what he had to say about Caitlin, about how she has such a great big heart, and it's the biggest heart that she has. And that's Bob. You know, it was like reflecting on Bob. What he sees in himself, he actually sees in Caitlin. And, there's no reason to wish these guys luck because they have it. You know, they have such a great foundation, and they're just wonderful together, and they're just pure. So, the bride and groom.
Thank you.
From everywhere. We have people from Kansas, we have people from the Carolinas, we have people down for coming, and we're so excited to share this moment with you. And I hope that you all enjoy the wedding as much as Bob and I enjoy having you guys here. And lastly, little tidbit for tomorrow. Bob and I are gonna do a bride and or a husband wife first breakfast at Pancake House in Bay Harbor. If anybody feels like stopping by, saying hi, you're more than welcome. We're going to be there about 9:30. So, anyways, just a little last thank you for coming, and hello again, and about it.
That's it. Thanks.
I believe Bill is the father of the groom going to offer blessing. Bill?
Blessing?
Oh, Bill, do you want to?
I don't want for comments already been said, okay. But we really appreciate you traveling miles to be with us here in this joyous occasion. Let us bow our heads. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for friends and family that have joined here today. Please be with our families that aren't with us. Please take this food and bless it to their intended use. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Bill.
Now don't be afraid to sing along.